In this video, you're going to learn how to build an AI agent that checks your Asana to-do list and sends a message in Slack every day, reminding you about what you have on your Asana to-do list. It's a really cool AI automation, and it's built completely without code using Zapier Central. Zapier Central is a little bit like Zapier's main app that you may have used before, but it uses AI to build AI agents. This is one of my favorite no-code tools that I've come across lately. I'm really enjoying building AI apps with it that provide real value, and I think you're really going to enjoy this tutorial. If you want to learn more about building with AI and no-code, check the link in the description to go to No-Code MBA, which is a learning platform that has over 60 in-depth courses teaching you how to build with no-code and AI tools. Now let's go ahead and get into this tutorial. So here we are in Zapier Central. If you don't have a Zapier Central account already, go to Zapier, search for Zapier Central and create an account, and go ahead and create a new bot. So here I've created a new bot. I've called it my Asana bot because we're going to connect to Asana and send the tasks to Slack. And I'm going to show you how I built this AI agent. So the first thing you need to know when you're inside Zapier Central and building a bot is what behaviors, instant actions, and data sources are. In our bot, we're only using behaviors, but I'm going to touch a little bit on what instant actions and data sources are. So behaviors allow you to build workflows inside of your bot. So I'm going to walk through our workflow that we created here in a minute, but the workflow is connecting to the different apps. So in our case, we're connecting to Asana and we're connecting to Slack to get those projects, and then we're going to post those projects or tasks into our Slack channel. So you can think of a behavior kind of like a workflow that you're building. And I'm going to show you in a minute how we build it and how Zapier uses AI to help you build those workflows. Instant actions I don't need to use here, but this is just an easy way to add a specific action. So let's just say we went into Gmail and we wanted to create an action to send an email. If we enable this in our bot, we could just chat to our bot and say, hey, send an email to whatever this specific email, asking a question about whatever you wanted to ask about. And then this bot now, because it has that ability, that instant action to send an email, it can do that. The bot is going to take in the information from your message and decide which instant action makes the most sense to use. Data sources allow you to add information to the chatbot as context. So something like an Airtable or Google Sheets or Google Doc or any of these six data sources right now. It looks like they're going to add future data sources later on. But what you can do is add, for an example, a Google Sheet, which has information about anything in your company. And then you can ask questions to this bot about that data source. So that's what instant actions and data sources are. But in this video, we're going to focus on behaviors. So what you want to do is click create behavior. I'm just going to go into the behavior that I'm already created. The first thing that you want to do is add a trigger for this action. So to start, what we want to do is just add the trigger and say when I message the bot, and then the trigger phrase is going to be get Asana tasks. Now, later on, we're going to switch this to being on a schedule. So what you can do is say, you know, every morning at 8 a.m., I want the bot to run this behavior. But in our case, we're just going to do it when I message the bot right now and get Asana tasks. The next thing that we want to do is add in instructions to follow. So this is essentially prompting the AI of what to do. So in our case, we're going to say get all projects with all their information. First, use the API request to get the tasks, then use the find tasks by ID request to get the specific info for each task, then post an update to Slack. So just copy this exact wording in the instructions to follow section for you. And then next, we need to add actions. So actions that this behavior has access to. So what you can, before we get into that, just as a way to think about how this works, is it's going to follow the instructions and then decide which actions to take that it has access to, which makes this really, really powerful. So we're going to get all projects with all their information by first using the API request to get all the tasks. I'm going to show you how to do that in the Asana Zapier connection. We need to do that first. Then it's going to use this action, finding tasks by ID. And then the final action is sending a private message to our Slack channel. So you can go ahead and click Add Action and then click Asana. And if you don't have an Asana account already, create an Asana account. If you do, go ahead and make sure that your Asana account is connected to your Zapier Central account, your Zapier account. And then once it's connected, you'll be able to click in and choose the task that you want to do. So you want to scroll all the way to the bottom. Mine doesn't have it because I'm already using it, but at the very bottom, there's going to be an action for API request. So we need to use the API request first. This is a little bit of an advanced technique, but the reason we need to do this is because this is the way Zapier doesn't give you a built-in connection to pull all of your tasks from a project. You can only get individual information about an individual task. So what we need to do is click this API request. You're going to, for HTTP method, instead of have AI select a field for you, which is really helpful, and I'll show you in a minute why when we do use that. But right now we're going to click set a specific value for the field. We're going to choose get because we're going to get information from our Asana. For the URL, again, we're going to set a specific value for this field. And then I'm going to show you where you get this URL. But you could just copy this exact URL if you want. It is essentially just, so it's HTTPS /app.asana.com/api/1.0/project/. This is your project ID, which I'll show you in a minute how to get, and then /tasks. For additional request headers, you can say, have AI generate. I think it's just going to be empty for those. So I believe you could also just say, do not include, but it doesn't really matter. And then we're not going to include any query string parameters, which would be additional information to pass through this API call. So we're essentially sending a message to Asana, and then it's going to send us back our tasks from this project. So real quick, I'm just going to show you how to get your project ID. So all you have to do is go to your project in Asana, go to the URL, and then get, it's this ID right here in the URL. So you can just copy that and then put that into your Zapier URL for the API call. And then also real quick, I'm going to show you how I got that URL for the API call. So I went to the Asana API reference. You could search Asana API reference in Google, go to get to this page, make sure you're on the API reference specifically, not the guides. You can see all of the different things you can do with their API, which is basically just ways to access your data or make changes to the data in Asana. So we're going to go down to tasks, and then we're going to search for the get tasks from project. And then that's where I got this URL here. So it's get, and then I just got the URL here. You can see it's exactly what we put in, except for our project ID, which I just showed you how to get. And then you put that into Zapier, and then you can see there are a few other things that you could do if you want, but these are just the query parameters that I mentioned if you wanted to add them in Zapier, but we do not need them in this example. Okay, so we can just go ahead and click Save Action or Update Action for me, and then you're going to add another action. So basically what this is going to do is give you the tasks and their ID, but we want to then have a second API call or a second. It's an API call, but it's done through Zapier, so it's a little easier to set up. It's just finding task by ID. So go ahead and click Add Action again. And then the action that you're going to look for is find task by ID. And what this is going to do is allow us to allow Zapier to take the ID it found in the previous API call for each of the tasks and find the task by ID. For task ID, we're going to say have AI generate a value for this field. This is where it gets really valuable, is having AI dynamically add fields into our Zapier tasks. So we can leave, should it be considered a success when nothing is found? We can just say, yeah, or have AI select a value is fine. There should always be something found in this example. So we're just going to go ahead and click Save Action. Okay. And what's really powerful about this is just by having both of these in and having the instructions to get all of the tasks and then use the find tasks by ID request to get specific info for each task, the AI will automatically loop through all of our tasks in this find task by ID to get all of the information about all of our tasks, which is really, really cool. Finally, we need to send a message to a private channel in Slack. So to do this, you just have to, again, add action, search for Slack. If you don't have a Slack connection, make sure you connect it with your Slack account, which is as easy as just pressing that connect button and then connecting it. And then you're going to want to scroll down until you see send private channel message. Now, you could do direct message or in a public channel. It doesn't really matter. In my case, I am sending to a private channel, and I created a private channel in Slack called Test Automation. So then when I go here to set a specific value for this field, I chose Test Automation. Now, if you kind of started this and then you created that Test Automation channel, you might need to click Refresh here to have all of your new channels show up. For message text, we're going to have AI generate a value for this field because it's going to generate that message based on the data. Send as a bot, we can just say, we can say yes. So it'll send as, it'll essentially send as like a Zapier bot, and you can have AI generate the name for the field and the icon, or you can set that if you want. But otherwise, if you say no to send as a bot, it'll just come from you in Slack. So that's really up to you. Everything else, have AI. I'm going to have AI select whether it's going to do the rest. And you can customize this more if you want. So all this is fairly straightforward based on just the settings that you want for your message. So we're going to go ahead and click save or update our action. And now what we can do is on the right side, click test behavior. So what this is going to do is go through, and it's going to go through each step. The AI is going to tell you what it's doing. So you can see here, it's first generating the preview. It's going to determine, and then it's going to ask you if it should proceed. So this is where if something seems wrong, you could give it feedback and it will save that feedback. But otherwise, I'm just going to say, yes, you should continue. So it's going to continue. And then one thing to note is once you turn on this behavior and you are actually using it from a trigger, it's just going to go through all of these steps on its own. It's not going to ask you in between each step. But when you're setting it up, it does ask you for feedback. So here we go. Okay, awesome. So it successfully fetched the tasks from the project, which are these three tasks. And you can see it has the tasks and then it has the IDs. But we don't have any other individual information about those tasks. So now that's what it's doing to using the find task by ID, the find task by ID action here. And here you can see, for that first one, now it found a lot more information about it. It found the priority, the due date, the starting date, the created at, the who it's assigned to, all of this information. And it's doing that for all of the tasks that it found, which is really, really cool. So it got all the information. Now it's generating a preview of our Slack message. So it's essentially using this information it just found about the projects and generating a Slack message with information about the tasks. Now, this is where you could be more specific. You could say, hey, write this in a paragraph style so it sounds like it's coming from a project manager. You could have it ask follow-up questions if something is late or something is past its due date. So there's a lot of things that you could do. You could also say, hey, let me know any tasks that were finished in the last day, for example, the last 24 hours. So there's a lot of things that you could do here to customize that final Slack message. But I'm going to just say, okay, great. This looks good. Let's proceed with sending this message to Slack. So it's going to think for a second, and it should send the message to Slack in just a second here. So here we are in Slack in my test automation channel, and we can see here it just sent this message. Here are the details of all the tasks from the Asana project. So it gave me all of the details here. So it worked, and it's successfully getting all of the tasks from Asana, putting it into a message and sending it in Slack. Now, the last step that we're going to want to do Actually, there's two more things that I would recommend doing. First, make sure you turn on this behavior. And you can see we have a trigger phrase here when I message the bot, get Asana tasks. So I'm going to exit out, and you can see we have our behaviors. We can click on them. We see retrieve all projects is on. And I'm just going to message the bot, get Asana tasks. And I like to do this just to test to make sure that your bot is working correctly. So it's going to go through all of those steps now. It's not going to ask you in between each step, like I mentioned. So I'm going to pause and just make sure that it's all working correctly before we schedule it on a daily schedule. All right, so we can see here on the right side thread where the Zapier Central bot is kind of telling us what it did. It says it did that first API request to get all the projects. Then it went through each project and found information about it. Then it sent that private channel message. And it says it successfully did it. Now, if for some reason yours did not work, you can provide feedback. You can reply and say, hey, that didn't work for this reason. And then the bot will get updated with information. But hopefully it should work. So now I'm just going to check Slack and make sure it posted. Cool. So here we are in Slack again, and we can see it posted that message. Okay, great. Now, if you wanted to, you could just leave it as that being the trigger. But what I like to do is go into this behavior and change this to start it when I'm going to clear out this trigger, and I'm going to search for schedule. Actually, that might not be correct. Schedule by Zapier. So just scroll down to schedule by Zapier. And then what I want to do is say every day. Let's say every day I want to trigger this, and I want to trigger it at, let's say, 8:45 a.m. every morning. I want to get that trigger. And then I can say trigger on weekends, yes or no. Let's say no. Let's say I only want to get this trigger on weekdays. And then now we don't really even have to test it again. It's already tested. If you want to, you can. But now, as long as that behavior is on, now every day at 8:45 a.m., that trigger is going to get triggered to start the behavior, and you're going to get a Slack message with your Asana tasks. So hopefully this was a helpful tutorial. I think Zapier Central is really cool. I'm really excited to use it for more use cases and dig into it even more. If you want to learn more about automating with AI or building apps with AI or building no-code apps using tools like Webflow, Bubble, Flutterflow, and more, check out the link in our description and go to No-Code MBA, a no-code and AI learning platform where you'll get access to over 60 full-length in-depth courses about how to build with no-code and AI. Thanks again for watching. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more videos like this in the future. And I'll see you in the next video.